It's a dangerous time to be a member of the press. In 2018, 43 journalists around the globe were killed because of their work, including Jamal Khashoggi, a Saudi Arabian journalist and columnist for The Washington Post, who frequently criticized the policies of the Saudi government. Last October, he walked into the Saudi Arabian consulate in Istanbul and was murdered. Another 155 journalists were imprisoned last year, including Shahidul Alam, a photojournalist from Bangladesh who criticized the government's deadly crackdown on a group of protesters last August. Alam was arrested and held in a jail cell in Bangladesh for more than 3 months before he was granted bail in November. Alam is in the United States and received an award from the International Center of Photography in New York, and he's with us today. It's so nice to have you.
Good to be here.
Thank you. You received death threats and have spent 107 days imprisoned and tortured as well. Can you explain to our audience why you were arrested?
I was recording a student protest. It was ostensibly about street danger. They wanted safer roads. In itself, that would have been fairly normal. I was being interviewed by Al Jazeera, and at that time they asked me why a road accident would have led to such a big protest. And in response, I mentioned that it was part of a much bigger protest against injustice, against repression. Obviously, that went against the interest of the government. They were leading up to an election, and I was a threat.
You have said that you feel fortunate to be a journalist in Bangladesh because your cause is very clear to you. You don't have to search for one. What do you mean?
If I were to compare it with journalism practiced elsewhere, in the United States, for instance, I think journalists have abdicated. A lot of what they do is PR. A lot of what they do is propaganda. And they're not asking the questions that need to be asked. It's dangerous in my country to be a journalist, but there are a few voices still making those noises, still standing up, still behaving as the fourth estate. And as a journalist, that's the terrain I want to be in. My life has meaning in a country like Bangladesh. Everything I do matters to the people around me. What I do is in the greater public interest.
I want to talk about some of your photographs that you've been honored for. We're going to pop the first one up, and it is a photo of a sailboat. Tell me a little bit about the backstory of this sailboat.
The story itself was about a river. It's an amazing river that starts in Tibet, goes through China into India and through Bangladesh into the Bay of Bengal. I was taking that photograph because the sailboat itself is dying. And now the motorboats have come in. It's a long tradition. There was a story about the picture itself because when I arrived, it was a murky day, and I stayed with the fishermen for a few days. And on the third day, there was this beautiful shaft of light that fell on that red boat. But for me, what's more significant is while I was in jail, my fellow prisoners decided that they wanted to paint a mural of that in jail as in honor of me. And while I've had that picture published in so many places, I now have a 12-foot mural inside Dhaka Kiranigan jail that remembers me.
Another photo is really capturing a moment in sort of the life of a migrant. Tell me about that one.
This was at our airport, and there's a little slit in the glass wall that separates passengers from, you know, the visitors. And it's only through that slit that you can speak or be heard. So a woman and a man, perhaps the man leaving for an unknown destination, not knowing when he might be back or if he will be back. And it was just a very tender moment. And often we forget that migrants are real people, that they have human emotions, that they are like you and me. And things that we accept as ambition, climbing up the social ladder, when it's for someone else, somehow we think it's no longer justified. That was what I wanted to get across.
You'll go back to Bangladesh on Sunday, and you have a court date on Monday, and you could end up incarcerated again. Why go back?
It's my country. A whole huge amount of people have sacrificed very, very much for this country's freedom. The least I can do is do my bit in that process. And as a journalist, as a writer, as a citizen, It is my job to stand up for the rights of my people. I will exercise my rights. I am a citizen of an independent nation, and I will exercise the rights that my constitution gives me. If others have a problem with it, they can deal with it.
Shahidul Alam, thank you for joining me. Appreciate it.
Thanks for being with us.